Hello everyone, I'm Tim from Tim Does Level Design and welcome to lesson 9 of my beginner course in video game level design. Now that your level is starting to come together and starts playing like how you imagined, you've likely playtested your own content what must feel like a million times already. It is extremely important to keep testing your own content to keep a grasp on what works and if any issues arise that you hadn't foreseen in the initial design. Though a key problem with using yourself as a test subject is that you, as the creator, already have all the information. You know the solution to challenging setups, and you're familiar with the layout, mechanics, and intended thematic. The more you work on your own project, the harder it becomes to see where new players might struggle or become confused. For this reason, larger video game companies tend to have their own in-house quality assurance team, or even use external companies to test their games in development. Though the QA department's main focus is usually to discover bugs and other issues for the developers to fix. To assess what gamers might think of the game, how difficult it is, and with which sections they struggle, companies usually host external playtests throughout development, where they bring in members of the public to test sections of the game after signing an NDA. Of course, we don't have the resources of a game development studio, but it's still very important for us to have our level prototypes tested to get an understanding of what actually works and what doesn't. For that purpose, let's explore how we can build and package our game project so we can share it with people to test without the need for them to install Unreal Engine. But first, let's think about our testing audience. Whether they are experienced platform game players or not, they won't have played this platform game prototype before. As our level doesn't take place at the beginning of the game, we expect our players to already have gone through tutorials, or at least have had a chance to get familiar with a bunch of abilities, LDIs, and enemies already. One option is to have our testers play the demo levels before starting our Q6 level. Though, in our level, we're introducing the Time Gem Gate LDI, the Teleport ability, and the Necromancer enemy for the first time. And if our testers are already familiar with these ingredients, it's difficult for us to assess how much a player might struggle with these elements or not. So you would either want to make some changes to the existing demo levels, removing the elements where you would want players to not yet be familiar with, or set up a smaller new test level where your test players can get familiar with all the elements of the game we already want them to be familiar with. In case you take this route, make sure there's an abundance of information panels available for them, or provide them with little cheat sheets of the game's controls and abilities. What we want to avoid is you having too much direct contact with the test subject and guiding them through the experience yourself. The more you interact with them, the more likely you are to change their experience and less likely they are to get stuck or frustrated somewhere, which is exactly the kind of stuff you want to find out with these tests. Also keep in mind that when people are engaging directly with the creator, they are less likely to say any mean things out of bias or politeness. With our test level or levels created, let's make sure our levels for this demo connect together by having a BP_level transition at the end of our test level and adding the name of our Q6 level in the details panel, so that when our test players are ready, they can move on to the actual test of Q6. But to make sure we can build and package our game, there are a couple of prerequisite things you need to have installed in your computer. Firstly, we need to make sure we have Visual Studio 2019 or later installed. When we Google Visual Studio download, we end up on Microsoft's Visual Studio page. I'll make sure to add the link of this page to this video's description. We need to press download and run the installer after downloading. After some time, it will prompt us with a window asking which components we would like to install. According to Epic, we should at least include the following optional workloads, so let's show they're selected. So we'll toggle on .NET desktop development with C++, and game development with C++. It seems that Universal Windows Platform Development has changed. So to be sure, let's toggle on Windows Application Development and hop into the Individual Components tab to make sure Universal Windows Platform Tools and Windows 10 or 11 SDK, depending on your Windows version, are selected as well. We can then press Install. The download and installation will take a while, depending on your internet speed. Unreal Engine also requires the .NET Core SDK to be installed to support certain build processes. So let's navigate to the .NET installation page on Microsoft's website to download it as well, and run it when it's finished downloading. Sometimes a computer reboot will be required after installing these. So let's do that to be on the safe side. After rebooting our computer, we can open up our project in Unreal Engine 5 again. Before packaging our game, we'll want to configure some settings which we can find on the platforms, and then packaging settings. Under description, if you want, you can fill out a custom description, project name, and upload a custom thumbnail. But I'll leave this all standard for now. Moving to the maps and modes category, we have to make sure our correct game default map is selected, which is what will load in the moment your test player opens the game. If you've customized some demo levels or set up a new test level for this purpose, this is where you'll want to select that one to load in. In packaging, under project, we'll want to change development to shipping and toggle on full rebuild to make sure everything we need is properly included in our package. Let's move to supported platforms and, assuming you're on Windows, make sure the Windows box is checked. Moving on to target hardware, we'll set the target hardware to desktop and maximum. We should now be ready to package our game. Under platforms, we should see Windows, as we enabled that as a target platform. Let's change the configuration to shipping and then press package project. We can now choose a location for a packaged game to be saved, and the packaging process should begin. We can press the output log to keep an eye on what's going on. Any potential issues should get listed here as well, but hopefully things will go smoothly. Now, during my first attempt, the output log indicated that some file paths were too long and it couldn't save the package. To try and resolve this, I needed to take a look at the folder structure and noticed some of the downloaded dressing asset packs had a lot of nested folders. I moved a bunch of assets into a simpler path, removed some unused assets and folders, and in project settings under packaging, selected only the tutorial map and the Q6 map specifically to be included in this package. This time around, when trying to package, everything seems to be going smoothly. If you run into any issues, you can always try to Google the specific error or hop onto the new Timdas Level Design Discord to ask myself and other members if they can help you resolve it. The link to the Discord will be added to the description of this video. After the packaging is done and assuming everything went well, we can find our game in our file explorer in the location we specified. Running it as a test, everything seems to work fine on my end. I'll rename the Windows folder and use WinRAR to compress it into a neat little package. To share this with people, we could copy it onto a USB stick or use a cloud service of choice like Google Drive, Microsoft OneDrive, or Dropbox, and get a shareable link that we can send to people. Now that we have our project ready to be tested by other people, we need to consider how we're actually going to get information to use from those tests. One common method is to give a short survey for people to fill out after testing your game. I'll use Google Forms for this purpose, though you're welcome to use any survey tool you can find, or even set up a simple document for people to fill out in any way you'd like. Let's fill out a title and a short description to give our testers a bit of context. There's much we can ask, but let's keep things simple and brief in this instance. For example, I'd like to know how difficult or challenging the tester experienced our level. I think it will be important for us to have a bit of context about the tester's experience level, as someone with no platformer game experience might find our game very challenging, where a more experienced player might find it trivially easy. I would like to know if there were any specific places the player got stuck, or if there were any really frustrating moments in the level, as those will be key points to address. Let's also not forget the positive things, and ask if there was anything in particular that did work well. You're free to ask any questions you'd like to get some information on, possibly about very specific sections of your level, like a boss fight at the end, or about difficult platforming moments in particular. But it's important to respect your tester's time, and if the questionnaire is too long, people might not bother with it. And keep in mind that multiple choice questions are always easier to answer. This whole exercise is just to get a first experience with other people playing your content and gathering some feedback. So for this purpose, we can keep things quite simple. As homework for this lesson, I'd like you to package your level, create a survey in whichever way you'd like, and have at the very least one person testing your level and giving you feedback. Of course, the more people test your level, the better, as individual results can vary wildly, but with a higher sample size, you'll get closer to the expected average. You can, of course, always ask friends or family to try out your level, but if you're feeling particularly brave, the internet is full of developer groups. Whether it's the Unreal Engine forums, Facebook groups, subreddits, or of course the TimDos Level Design Discord. Though, do keep in mind which groups might be most representative of your target audience. In this Level Design Beginner course, we've now learned about various elements, like level design ingredients and enemies, creating and using gym levels, creating level blockouts, design documents and methods, placeholder art, and how to test and iterate on our content. I think we've covered a good starting point on your journey as a level designer and given you all the tools needed to continue fleshing out your level and create more levels from scratch. In the next and final lesson of this series, if you'd like to continue learning more about level design and possibly get into the game industry, I'd like to briefly talk about the possible next steps and other places to find more information so you can keep improving yourself. Please do like and subscribe, and hit that notification bell below to get notified when the next video goes live. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.